Sports Zone starts now. Sponsored by U.S. Cellular.
The fact that I can represent, like, the little girls out there who've wanted to do this or, you know, thought about playing football or any sport, really, and it encourages them to be able to step out and do something big like this.
Well, it was a pretty awesome moment, a historic day at Faurot Field. It was not about the final score. It wasn't about COVID-19. It wasn't even about how many tackles Nick Bolton had, which was a lot, if you were wondering. No, it was about this woman breaking down a barrier. And Mizzou, well, they got to host Vanderbilt today on a historic Saturday afternoon. These guys were ready today. First quarter, Connor Bazelak hits Toski Dove. Look at him go. And that would set up Larry Rountree. Bazelak, he had a pretty good day, but Larry Rountree always seems to be having a good day here. Bazelak with a handoff to Rountree. 7 yards to the house. The land of six. It's looking pretty nice for Larry Rountree this time of year. 7-0 Mizzou. Like I said, Rountree just having an outstanding season. Watch this. He can't go this way, so no, never mind. I'm just going to turn around, go that way. Try to get me down. No, never mind. I'm just going to keep going. Get off of him. Don't even try at this point. He sets himself up pretty nicely. And this guy seemed pretty excited. Nice moves, kid. Larry Rountree would get his second touchdown of the game. 14-0. Mizzou, the Tigers, really looked unstoppable today. Later, Bazelak again. This time would hit Tyler Beatty. The man is running, and it looks like he got in, but his elbow was down, and they placed it on the 1 yard line. But no worries, he did get it in on the next play, and that would make it 21-0 at the half. And ending on a pretty cool moment here, Brady Cook. The freshman, the St. Louis native, heaves it up and hits Damon Hazelton for a touchdown. His very first one as a Tiger. So the Tigers did shut out the Commodores today, 41-0. What a day for Larry Rountree, 160 yards and 3 touchdowns. Connor Bazelak didn't have any scores, but just listen to this stat line. 316 yards with an 80% completion percentage. I'd say that's a pretty good day, but how about that defense, a shutout? And we heard more from Mizzou about that defense after the game.
Yeah, great team win today. Thought our defense really played lights out. To hold an SEC opponent under 200 yards and a shutout, forced a turnover, stopped them on that early fourth down, which led us to our first scoring drive of the game. Can't say enough about Coach Walters and the job that that defense has done the past two games. Really set up our football team to have some momentum and string some wins together. Offensively, I thought we played efficient. Obviously, Larry Rountree had a big day.
We put our foot down, basically saying we're going to fight for four quarters and not go to sleep in the second quarter. I feel like we ain't been playing good ball for these past two games in the second half, which this game we showed up and put our foot down and played all four quarters. You know, it's obviously, you know, things we can work on, but I would say what was different was the mindset of us finishing them, you know, and actually going out the second half and playing our game.
Well, I'd like to welcome in our Fox viewers. You are coming in at just the right time. Sarah Fuller will be going down in history. That is absolutely no question. I mean, it can't get more 2020 than the entire country rooting for Vanderbilt's offense to just get in good enough field position for a field goal. Today, the Vanderbilt soccer standout became the first woman to start in a Power 5 football game with her kickoff at the start of the second half. Athletes around the world were praising her, but it seems like worldwide recognition isn't really the most important thing to her. It's the kids and also inspiring this football team.
I just wanted more energy on the sidelines and going from the, I know I'm going to keep relaying it back to the SEC championship, but like our sidelines and everything was just what kept us going the entire time. And so I just wanted to go in there and say, hey guys, we need to get pumped up, and whether we're down or we get a first down or whatever it is, like we need to cheer each other on, because that's the only way I've seen it work. It's just everybody supporting one another. I tend to be more like aggressive and straightforward, and so I feel like my speeches and everything weirdly fit better with a football team more so than our soccer team.